and we have ceased fighting anything or anyone, even alcohol. For by this time sanity will have returned. We will seldom be interested in liquor. If tempted, we recoil from it as from a hot flame. We react sanely and normally, and we will find that this has happened automatically. We will see that our new attitude toward liquor has been given us without any thought or effort on our part. It just comes. That is the miracle of it. We are not fighting it. Neither are we avoiding temptation. We feel as though we had been placed in a position of neutrality, safe and protected. We have not even sworn off. Instead, the problem has been removed. It does not exist for us. We are neither cocky, nor are we afraid. That is our experience. That is how we react, so long as we keep in fit spiritual condition.
Now, what we have in the next paragraph are called the 10-step promises. Now, this is providing that I've done everything up to this point, meaning I've had a first-step experience, I found a power greater than me, I made a decision to give my life to that God, I did an inventory, shared it with another person, took the exact nature of my wrongs to God in 6 and 7, compiled my harm list from my inventory, began making my amends, and began practicing the 10-step during the day. Check out the magnitude of these guarantees as we read on. And we have ceased fighting anything or anyone, even alcohol. Wow. Would you like to be able to stop fighting anything or anyone? Does that sound cool or what? For by this time, sanity will have returned. I am guaranteed to experience what the author's experienced. That has been my personal experience. I've also had the experience of not experiencing these promises when I don't do the work. We will seldom be interested in liquor. If tempted, we recoil from it as from a hot flame. We react sanely normally. Wow. React sanely normally. That's so foreign to me. And when we will find that this has happened, check this out. And we will find that this has happened automatically. It doesn't say that I'm making it happen. We will see that our new attitude, there's that word again, new. New attitude, not attitude, but new attitude. That means different than it was before. Toward liquor has been given us without any thought or effort on our part. In other words, I'm not making it happen. All I'm simply doing is I'm just simply doing the footwork. It just comes. That is the miracle of it. We're not fighting it, neither are we avoiding temptation. We feel as though we have been placed in a position of neutrality, safe and protected. Am I in a position of neutrality? Do I feel safe and protected? We have not even sworn off. Instead, the problem has been removed. It does not exist for us. We're neither cocky nor are we afraid. That is our experience. Then they go on to tell us that is how we react so long as we keep in fit spiritual condition. They're giving us a little checklist. It has been my experience, personally, as well as observing people I've worked with through the years in these rooms, that there's fundamentally only one reason why I will drink again. And that's because I'm not in fit spiritual condition. If I am in fit spiritual condition, it is impossible for me to drink. My God will not let it happen. Ask yourself, well, how am I going to know if I'm fit spiritual condition? They just got through telling us. This is how we react. So I have a little checklist. Let's see if I'm in fit spiritual condition. I go back and I start reading the beginning of that paragraph. Have I ceased fighting anything or anyone? Or am I getting into arguments with people all the time? Getting into debates? Getting on a crusade? Got to convince you this is the way you got to do the program. This is, for this time, Sandy will have has Sandy returned? Are you seldom interested in liquor and attempted? Have you been able to recoil from it as from a hot flame? Are you reacting sanely and normally? It says we're not fighting it. We feel as though we've been placed in a position of neutrality, safe and protected. Now, if I am truly spiritually fit, and if I am truly in a position of neutrality, safe and protected, you know what that means? That means you cannot harm me. If I'm in a position of neutrality, how are you going to hurt me? What are you going to do? Steal my truck? Go ahead, take it. God's just going to give me another one. You want my money? Follow me. Follow me outside of the meeting, you know, where it's dark, and I go out to my truck and pull out a knife or a gun and say, I want your money. I say, okay, here, take it. Why? Because I'm safe and protected. God's just going to give me more. I can go anywhere. I've been to places that people have told me not to go. Let's take it to the extreme. Let's say you get really resentful at me and you decide you want to kill me. Bring it on. I'm just going to a better place. That's what being safe and protected means. It means I'm no longer living in fear. That doesn't mean I don't experience fear. I'm not driven by fear anymore. Because I've become clear as a result of following the recipe in this book that I'm a spiritual being with a human condition.
Step 10, your spiritual condition. And we have ceased fighting anything or anyone, even alcohol, for by this time sanity will have returned. So in the book Alcoholics Anonymous, sanity is talking about not picking up that first drink. Because an alcoholic, once they put alcohol in their body, once I put alcohol in my body, I physically crave it. And that's why I'm powerless. My willpower will not stop that. And Dr. Silkworth talks about that in The Doctor's Opinion. And he basically describes what an alcoholic is and what alcoholism is. When you put alcohol in your body, an alcoholic physically craves it. That's an alcoholic, period. It's not about consequences or situations, divorces, bankruptcy, jail, car wrecks, lost jobs, divorces, bankruptcy, none of that. That's all drama. An alcoholic is a person, once they put alcohol in their body, they physically crave it, period. The end. So to be restored to sanity means we're not picking up the first drink. I'm not picking up the first drink. And step two, it says, came to believe that a power greater than ourselves could restore us to sanity. So here's your sanity on page 84. Restored to sanity. I have no longer desire to drink alcohol. Later in the book, they'll talk about alcohol as just a symptom. It's not the cause. It's a symptom. And in step four, it talks about we had to get down to causes and conditions. A cause produces a result, and a condition is a state of mind. So liquor is a symptom because I'm spiritually sick. I have a spiritual malady. And it goes on to say, we will seldom be interested in liquor. If tempted, we recoil from it as from a hot flame. We react sanely and normally, and we will find that this has happened automatically. We will see that our new attitude toward liquor has been given us without any thought or effort on our part. It just comes. That's the miracle of it. We're not fighting it, nor are we avoiding temptation. We feel as though we have been placed in a position of neutrality, safe and protected. We're not even sworn off. Instead, the problem has been removed. It does not exist for us. We're neither cocky nor afraid. That is our experience. That's how we react so long as we keep in fit spiritual condition. So that's the big book authors said that's our experience. That's not a theory or opinion. That's an experience. That's something that has happened by going through the 12 steps of Alcoholics Anonymous. And they just described your spiritual condition. Do you meet the criteria? Have you ceased fighting? Has your sanity been returned? And we have this new attitude. So I just wanted to pass this on. This is, again, anything that gives you hope in the big book is a promise. And here's some promises. You know, you hear in the meetings all the time, the 9-step promises. Check out the step 10 promises. Pretty awesome.